Hello and welcome to another update video. Today we want to talk about Coinbase. Coinbase has basically moved up together with the crypto market, basically in line with expectations. What it though it didn't do was to give us any decent pullback really along the way. I mean, in the last updates, I rather had the problem not that support levels broke, but rather that the price didn't dip down deep enough. This wave four, I have to say, was a little bit less deep than I wanted it. And also this B wave was very, very shallow. But that's exactly what we see when we're analyzing cryptocurrencies as well, which we do on our main channel, More Crypto Online, that in a bullish market, and the crypto market is bullish, and Coinbase, even though it's not a cryptocurrency, obviously it is completely influenced by the crypto market. Okay, maybe not completely, but to a large degree. Obviously, when the crypto market is profiting, Coinbase attracts more customers, then, you know, good fundamentals, things like that. So obviously the hype also spills over to crypto charts and crypto stocks, or from crypto charts to crypto stocks. So we have the same, let's say, phenomenon that pullbacks are extremely shallow. So what we're doing here is we are in this uptrend. It's not impulsive in my interpretation. It is a diagonal pattern because we have too many overlaps and the proportions just don't give me that impulsive characteristic. You know, we have overlapping price action. We have still, even though it was rather shallow that way forward, for an impulse, it was very, very deep. So it all, you know, it all fits into the picture of a diagonal. The problem with a diagonal is, from an Elliott wave point of view, they can easily extend and you don't have a very reliable wave count. Okay, it's a wave structure that's characterized by sometimes deep pullbacks, sometimes pullbacks that are less shallow than ideal, you know. So diagonals, they are a bit tricky, but still it is an uptrend as long as support levels are holding. We can use the Elliott waves to understand the next targets and which support levels need to hold to maintain the perspective of an active uptrend. Let me talk you through the two scenarios. In the first scenario, we have this yellow wave count. And but I can't remember what I highlighted here in the last video when I made it. I do update Coinbase regularly, you know, for members. However, what I highlighted, I'm pretty sure, in the last video was this target range between $242 and $358, and possibly already the more specific target range between $272 and $332. And that was reached. And I highlighted that we might just need one more high to complete this uptrend. And that's precisely what we've seen, only with shallow pullbacks, as I have to say, so less deep than desired. Okay, would have liked to see a bit of a deeper wave four, but fine. Okay, so certainly didn't break the uptrend. So we have here this diagonal pattern in which we had an initial 1-2 setup. That was the wave two in June. Then an A, B, C in wave three. It's a clear three wave move. The third wave did what it needed to do. That's the yellow count. Then a wave four, that was very shallow, and that prompted me to think about alternative interpretations. And I'll show you the alternative, which is actually now, funny enough, my preferred scenario. And then a fifth wave to the upside, which is still valid, okay? Absolutely still a valid scenario. But the thing is, as soon as this is completed and there's no strong sign it is yet, it would be a completion of a five wave pattern, a leading diagonal in wave five of one. We're in the target area. We haven't maxed it out yet. Bear in mind, extensions are always possible, but we've reached the area that where we need to get cautious. And from here, a deep wave two pullback could start. Now, getting down to $120 from here seems far-fetched. So that's why I thought about this white scenario. Let me just change the wave degree. It's a little bit different. In the white scenario, I just have repositioned the waves one and three. And the idea is that instead of wave one completing here in February 23, it instead finished in July. And that was here the top at around $116 pretty much. Then we had a wave two pullback, which bottomed here in September last year. And this is now a third wave, which is an A, B, C structure. And the third wave seems to be still unfolding. And that's all good. That third wave could still stretch a little higher, possibly to 308, $332 next. And after the third wave is done, we should get away for pullback and then one more high. And that is also, to be honest, more in line with my own Bitcoin wave count. So I like that a little bit more. Either way, there is in both scenarios currently no sign that a top is in place. Okay, so it can still stretch higher in both the fifth wave in yellow, which is now the alternative count, or the third wave in white. And I would have to adjust the support area here for the fourth wave higher as we climb a little higher. At the moment, the support region for the fourth wave would be between $140 and $202. And it is important for further direct upside extensions in this wave count and to reach those next upside targets that the price stays above $248, or rather $249. I mean, that's very close together. It's just this swing low that formed a few days ago. And as long as we stay above that level, further direct extensions higher to, $308 next are likely and are to be expected. A break below 249 would suggest that a top of sorts has formed and that maybe this is the start of the wave four in the white count, or even the A wave of a larger wave two in the yellow count. So these are the key parameters to watch. In the short term, therefore, the price can still go higher. Doesn't have to. I mean, even here, the requirements for the white count are now complete, and I think it's now worth watching. All eyes need to be, you know, on that $249 level. That's my update about Coinbase. Hope you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe. And if you're interested in daily updates about the S&P 500, as well as regular updates about stocks, then feel free to check out our stocks and S&P 500 service. You'll find the link in the description. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.